How do you think you'll be remembered at Lower High School?
Hopefully the GOAT. I want to be the GOAT here, like the greatest of all time from Lower. That would be dope. That would be hella dope.
Right here we got Amare. Here we like, right here we got the greatest, the GOAT, the legend, the myth. Well, greatest of all time, the best to ever do it, touch the ball, everything. Well, and I get to watch it, like, you know what I mean? Like, I just get to see it with my eyes, fool. So, you know, my man, fool, that's really, like, my kin. I really want to see him. I really want to see him do great things, fool. I know.
What made you move to Lower?
During COVID 2020, it was just everything was locked down in the West Coast, so my mom and pops, they made me move out here.
How was it adapting to the East Coast after living on the West Coast for so long?
It was hard. For like the first couple of months, it was hella hard. Like, I didn't really know nobody, I didn't fit in like that, so it was hard. But after a couple months or two, it was cool. Now it's home.
I did all my sets, I'm the only one. Me and Marco.
I did all my.
You were 4-8 Offensive Player of the Year, junior year. What was it about Lower that made you stay instead of transferring and looking for more exposure?
It was like a family vibe over here that I caught my first year over here. So it was like, shit, I can't leave them. Like, these my brothers for life. It's all about loyalty for me.
What do you want to say to the school that didn't recruit you?
Y'all messed up because if I get a chance to play y'all, crazy. Especially the schools that's around here, like local schools, is gonna be.
What were the factors that ultimately helped you make your decision to commit to this school?
The family over there, they're up and coming. They had a 7-4 season last year in the receiver room. They're not that deep, so it was just a no-brainer. They want me to come here and make a statement, so it'd be cool.
What are your goals going into college?
At least play my freshman year, get on the field, get a 3.0 GPA, of course, so I don't gotta go to study hall. Freshman All American, first team All Freshman or something.
He's trying to double the weight, that's all it is.
What is he trying to do?
Get a 35-pound plate.
What's he tell you though?
Come on, baby, it's your 35.
Since meeting him, how have you seen Mark grow as a player and as an overall person?
Over these past 2 years, I definitely can say I've seen a big difference, especially with leadership. You know, not much of a talker. You know, I'm gonna show you more than you can tell you. But as far as comparing last year to this year, it definitely seen a big difference as maturity, his growth, and work ethic. Definitely can see that.
What separates Mark from his competition?
Resilience, out there. He's a fighter. No matter what he's going through, he's going to fight. No matter what the school board says, he's going to fight. Resilience.
In the weight room, 2 on Wednesday, so we're doing both.
Who?
SOF on me, SOF on three. 1, 2, 3.
SOF. And also, maybe speak a little bit about where he's going. All right, Trey, go ahead.
Missing a single game or snap and making it when nobody else could. To my mom taking me to every single camp, showcase, and visit I've ever asked for. I would like to thank all of the coaches. Right, this catch right here definitely affected me and made me have a different look for the game. With all of that being said, I'm extremely grateful for the position that I'm in, especially when I could be in way worse. And for the next 3 or 4 years of my life, I will be taking my talents to Frostburg State University. Thank you to Coach Kidd.
All right, so Frostburg State. So again, congratulations to Josh, Frostburg State University. Didn't play in 2020-2021 here at Laurel. I know Amare was here with us that year. So they lost a year. So they have a year less of film, a year less of recruitment. So it's really commendable that they got to where they are today. Amare came that COVID year when we were virtual. And I'll never forget, Ms. Taylor, the main office secretary, called me and said, hey, a father called me and emailed me his highlight tape. I was like, all right, that happens all the time. Cool. Can you send it to me? She sent it to me. I watched it and I was like, oh boy.
How you bring a knife to a gunfight? They gon' always do it twice when it's done right. I remember riding around to the sun like, come on. Ain't tryna argue, so I hung up. Every time we outside, it be going up. I got women tryna get at me like you been growing up. Really, I know you see what's happening, I'm steady blowing up. I know you want me to fall, but I'm steady going up, yeah. Started from the bottom, how the fuck I'm up here? If you really came from nothing, then you know how that feel. Ain't no issues on the step, it's just the way that I live. There's some issues on the list, that's what I do.
All right, so I'm gonna give the mic over to Amare, who's gonna introduce who's at his table and make his decision.
What's up, y'all? What's up? With me, I'm with my dad, my stepmom right there, my little brother right there, and my other little brother in the stroller. And I'm gonna start my speech. I forgot it, but I'm gonna go off from the chest. So, first off, I wanna thank God for putting me in the position I am today. Like, without him, I wouldn't be like, I'm God-gifted. Like, a lot of people aren't like me. They don't get the opportunity to play at the next level. They don't get the opportunity to have the talent like me. So I'm just blessed. So I want to thank my mom, my dad, my stepmom, all my family members. Like, without them, I wouldn't be me for real. They made me. Like, I act just like them for real, for real. It's crazy. But I love them. I love their support. And I want to thank them for everything. And then I want to thank my support system, everybody in here. Like, I love y'all the fam, for real, for real. I'll never forget Laurel, for real, for real. On my life, I'll never forget Laurel. But with that being said, for the next 3 to 4 years, I'll be attending. West Virginia State University.
What was going through your head when you sat down at the table before you committed?
I was just excited that I was able to, my dream was coming to reality, like I'm finally going to college, finally able to like shoot my dreams in college, ready to work and stuff.
Do you feel like you left high school how you wanted to?
Yeah, I don't got no regrets, but I just wanted to win a little bit more my senior year. But it's cool though.
All right, so
did you always know you would be here, or did you have self-doubt at times?
Yeah, I had self-doubt sometimes, like during the, like not during the COVID, but after 11th grade year, I went crazy, and a lot of people were getting endless attention, and every college I came to the school was just making up some excuse, like why they couldn't bag me. But now it is what it is. Now I found my home, and every school gonna regret it. But yeah, I always, yeah. Basically, I doubted myself, but I always knew I was gonna come up one day, yeah.
Tell me about how you got your first offer and how it felt.
I got my first offer my freshman year after my second game. I had 4 touchdowns, and then the next morning the BYU coach called my coach and offered me, bro, off the back. And then after I got that offer, I thought I made it. Like, I'm not even gonna lie, I already knew football was something I wanted to do. So after that, it just made me want to push more.
Either one, don't matter. But what's my name?
I am.
AKA.
You gotta go.
What?
I got a question.
They look nice. No.
Students, at 12:24, when that bell rings, you go to fourth lunch.
I'm out of school.
Fourth lunch at 12:24, you have to be at it.
Hey, I need all those cone drills, bro. All of them. I'm about to be wide out. I'm about to be like a little Deshaun guy.
Jaleel and Marco, come up here. Jaleel.
I'm about to introduce you to the camera right now. Excuse me.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Hey, Mama. You can hear me? Thank you, bro. You want the sweater and the hat?
Yeah.
Hey, say what's your mom, this is the camera right here. The camera on, I'm getting a little duck. Thank you.
Who motivates you?
My mom, my dad, really my mom though. I just want to see her win in life, so I'm trying to do everything I can to make her win, help her succeed.
Oh, you want a sweater? I got you. You can have this one. You can have this one. Yeah. You got it? Yeah, I signed and everything. I got a sweater.
Yeah. I love you. Congratulations.
I love you too, Mom. I said I love you too.
She hung up on me. Hey, she just hung up on me.
Hello, you hung up on me. Yeah, you hung up on me, mama.
Damn.
Yeah, but I'm committed, you know.
Go back to work. Congratulations.
All right, I love you.
I love you, son.
All right, mom. All right, bye.
What do you want to say to the kids that look up to you, or the younger generation or younger class, man, football just, players?
Just keep working. Don't ever give up on your dream. If you want to be a football player, just keep thriving, keep working. Do whatever you want to do. If you whatever you want to do, just keep thriving, keep working. You gonna do it. You gonna succeed in it. But if you doubt yourself, then there's no point in doing it. What you're doing.